According to a famous line from William Shakespeare's Twelfth Night, some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. In a previous TB video, Einstein and the Cult of Celebrity, I argued that Einstein belonged in the latter camp. He was as much a victim as a genius at a time when science took a wrong turn and theoretical physics, math magic, some say, began to take precedence over traditional empiricism. To be fair to Einstein, I also pointed out that he was a modest man and a reluctant hero. In a 1949 letter to his friend Morris Solovine, he confessed, quote, "There is not a single concept of which I am convinced that it will stand firm, and I feel uncertain whether I'm in general on the right track." Have you ever heard this quote from popular science sources? The truth is that others ran with his ideas and ran and ran. Today they are still running around like dogs sniffing each other's butts. The talking heads trotted out on television invariably give the impression that the science is settled and that general and special relativity are beyond reasonable doubt. As we will see, however, there are many good reasons to doubt consensus certainty. Black holes and belief. Consensus scientists are fond of describing black holes as one of the most successful predictions of relativity, despite Einstein himself dismissing the notion. He concluded that the concept of a singularity, a region of zero volume and infinite density, was not convincing and did not reflect physical reality. Claims that a black hole has been pictured for the first time at the center of galaxy M87 are at best contentious. The pictures of the supposed black hole were composite and have been widely criticized. This extract from universemagazine.com concluded, quote, that the photo of 2019 turned out to be false. By contrast, plasma cosmology offers a more grounded explanation for active galactic centers. These regions resemble plasmoids, torus-shaped electromagnetic phenomena replicated in laboratory experiments. Unlike black holes, plasmoids rely on observable plasma behaviors that are known to scale across many orders of magnitude. Leonard Susskind and Stephen Hawking debated the nature of black holes for decades. This was handed down for posterity by Susskind in his book, The Black Hole War. The argument ended shortly before Hawking's death in January 2014, with Hawking's admission that there is no event horizon and therefore no black hole in the sense of the theory. Hawking recommended redefining black holes as a five-dimensional space. In other words, more math, less meaning, and still no empirical confirmation. Problem with theoretical physics. Einstein is often hailed as one of the greatest scientists of all time, but many argue that theoretical physicists occupy a different category. Unlike classical science, which demands empirical verification, theoretical physics all too often elevates mathematical elegance over observable truth. Einstein himself once remarked, quote, "As far as the laws of mathematics refer to reality, they are not certain. And as far as they are certain, they do not refer to reality." In other words, math is a tool, not a substitute for observation. When mathematical models become idealized to the point of abstraction, they can mislead rather than enlighten. The infamous epicycles of geocentric astronomy were mathematically consistent and predictive, yet fundamentally wrong. Today's equivalents are dark matter and dark energy, together accounting for an estimated 95% of the universe, yet neither has been detected after decades of searching. As Bertrand Russell quipped, quote, "Physics is mathematical not because we know so much about the physical world, but because we know so little." Gravity and geometry. Isaac Newton described gravity with great mathematical precision, but admitted he did not know its cause. Quote, "But hitherto I have not been able to discover the cause of those properties of gravity from phenomena, and I frame no hypotheses." Close quote. Einstein sought to improve upon this by introducing time as a fourth dimension, leading to the concept of curved spacetime. In mathematical geometry, where mass tells space how to curve, and space tells mass how to move. But does this abstraction illuminate gravity, or does it obscure the underlying mechanism? The classic rubber sheet analogy used to explain curved spacetime is misleading. It uses gravity, a weight depressing the sheet, to explain gravity. This circular reasoning has not gone unnoticed. Mathematician Stephen Crevers has dissected the logical flaws and internal inconsistencies in the curved spacetime paradigm. Physicist Sir Oliver Lodge once joked that if a new geometry is required to explain a falling apple, many complications would ensue. The speculative concept of curved space can certainly lead to some interesting mental gymnastics. Quote, a straight line is a special case of a curve. It's a curve which is uncurved, close quote, Leonard Susskind. Gravitational lensing or atmospheric refraction. One of the most famous confirmations of general relativity was the 1919 solar eclipse experiment, in which starlight was observed to bend near the sun, supposedly proving Einstein right. But was this really due to curved spacetime? Dr. Edward Dowdier, a physicist and former NASA optics engineer, challenged this interpretation. He showed that light passing through the sun's ionized outer atmosphere would naturally experience refraction, similar to how a stick appears bent when placed in water. Dowdier also noted a critical omission. No gravitational lensing has been observed around the fast-orbiting stars near the Milky Way's galactic center. These conditions should produce dramatic lensing effects if general relativity holds. The absence of such observations undermines the foundational claims of the theory. Quote, evidence of gravitational light bending at the site of Sagittarius A, as is predicted by the light bending rule of general relativity, is yet to be observed, close quote, Dr. Edward Dowdier. GPS, Global Positioning System and Time Dilation. Time dilation has been cited as conclusive evidence for special relativity, but could bias confirmation be the significant factor here? In 1972, Heffeli and Keating performed experiments that purported to confirm special relativity. The evidence was derived from the differences in time recorded by cesium clocks transported in aircraft moving east and west. However, the results were contested by Dr. A.G. Kelly after examining the raw data. He concluded that the published outcome had to be averaged in a biased way to claim such a high degree of precision. Also, Louis Essen, the inventor of the atomic clock, published an article in which he discussed the inadequate accuracy of the experiments. Essen concluded the theory was no more than a, quote, bunch of contradictory assumptions together with actual mistakes. In light of these facts, relativistic claims relating to GPS can be challenged. It should be noted that adjustments are made, but this is because clocks at high altitude tick faster, resulting from variations in air density, not gravity. The air is denser closer to the Earth's surface. Atomic clocks are also sensitive to temperature and pressure changes in their orbit. Dr. Tom von Flanden worked on the US Naval Observatory team that developed and commissioned a GPS. Using Newtonian mechanics, he produced the same results precisely. This begs the question, why were his findings ignored? Quote, when experimental evidence is incompatible with mainstream scientific theories, mainstream scientists refuse to acknowledge this to avoid jeopardizing their funding. Close quote, Tom von Flanden. Spooky action and speed limits. Einstein coined the term spooky action at a distance, latterly referred to as quantum entanglement. It seems that one particle can know something about another particle instantaneously over a vast distance. This phenomenon is problematic because it breaks the speed of light barrier, supposedly the upper speed limit of the universe. Because it contradicts special relativity, Einstein said he couldn't, quote, seriously believe in it. SAD, spooky action at a distance, has been confirmed post-Einstein. This is a big problem for orthodoxy. While quantum mechanics has enabled numerous scientific and technological advances, it remains incompatible with relativity. Quantum superposition conjectures that particles can exist in different states simultaneously, much like the burglar who claimed to be at home when he was seen robbing a store. Feynman poked fun at such ideas. Quote, "I think I can safely say that nobody understands quantum mechanics," close quote, Richard Feynman. It can also be argued that if gravity propagates between the Sun and Earth at the same speed as visible light in about 8 minutes, the Earth will double the distance from the Sun every 1,200 years, which isn't happening. Many other notable physicists besides Newton and Lorentz also concluded that orbital calculations must be made using an infinite speed of gravity. Sir Arthur Stanley Eddington's orbital calculations rely on gravity having an infinite speed, and Pierre-Simon Laplace calculated gravity to have a speed of at least 10 to the power of 8 times the speed of light. The ether question. Einstein's theories eliminated the need for an ether or quintessence, a medium once thought necessary for the propagation of electromagnetic waves. But this created a paradox. Maxwell's equations, which form the bedrock of classical electromagnetism, require a medium for wave propagation. The ether can be thought of as a fine elastic medium or plenum that permeates everything. The question remains, how can light, a wave, travel through the vacuum of space with no medium to oscillate in? How can nothing wave is a question that standard physics has never adequately answered. In the early 20th century, Data Miller conducted extensive interferometer experiments atop Mount Wilson and claimed to detect ether drift, an effect Michelson and Morley failed to find. Einstein admitted that if Miller were correct, his theory would collapse. In 1998, the respected physicist and Nobel laureate, Maurice Allais, published a rigorous analysis of Data Miller's 1925-26 experimental results in the magazine 21st Century Science and Technology. He concluded that Einstein's theories did not align with observed reality. Quote, "Consequently, the special and general theory of relativity, resting on postulates invalidated by observational data, cannot be considered as scientifically valid." Herbert Dingle, a former president of the Royal Astronomical Society, went even further, arguing that Einstein's work had discarded physical meaning in favour of abstract mathematics. Wallace Thornhill of the Electric Universe Community summarised the problem succinctly. Quote, "Einstein removed any possibility that he or his followers would find a link between electromagnetism and gravity." Einstein and Tesla. Tesla is to alternative or underground science as Einstein is to popular science, a cult hero. However, while Einstein's work was confined to theoretical physics, Tesla's life was characterized by practical achievement. Renowned for his groundbreaking work in electrical engineering and electromagnetism, he is sometimes hailed as the man who invented the 20th century. Quote, "Tesla has contributed more to electrical science than any man up to his time," close quote, Lord Kelvin. As a practical man and inventor, Tesla's eventual clash with Einstein's more theoretical approach to physics was perhaps inevitable. This divide may have contributed to marginalization in his later years, when theoretical physics gained dominance in the scientific community. Tesla, who also insisted on the existence of an ether, luminiferous ether he called it, was a vociferous critic of Einstein and general relativity. Quote, "Today's scientists have substituted mathematics for experiments, and they wander off through equation after equation, and eventually build a structure which has no relation to reality," close quote, Nikola Tesla. While Einstein achieved fame and fortune during his lifetime, Tesla passed away in relative poverty and obscurity. Parroted genius? As legend has it, when Einstein was asked, "Who is the smartest person you have met?" he responded, "My chauffeur." When asked why this was, he said, Quote, he stood in for me once when I was feeling ill. Having heard my lecture more than 300 times, he was able to repeat it word for word and even answer questions afterwards. Close quote. But science is not a personality cult. Ideas must stand on evidence, not a celebrity. Legacy and context. Einstein's critics can be uncompromising. Some go so far as to claim that the near-canonical status of his theories has delayed scientific progress by a century or more. Before rushing to judgment, context is essential. When Einstein introduced his theories in the early 20th century, the Milky Way was still believed to constitute the entire universe, and gravity was considered the sole force shaping cosmic structure. The fourth state of matter, plasma, had yet to enter the astronomer's lexicon. Today, we know that over 99% of the visible universe is plasma. Electromagnetic fields sculpt galaxies, light up nebulae, and power cosmic jets. The cosmos is not electrically neutral, but charged and dynamic. Einstein's achievements were remarkable for their time, but science must evolve. As he himself warned, quote, unthinking respect for authority is the greatest enemy of truth. The road ahead lies in evidence-based inquiry, where models serve observations, not the other way around. Plasma cosmology and the electric universe deserve a place at the table. The electric universe advocates for a return to the ether theory of classical physics. A revival of the ether concept, far from being obsolete, could help explain puzzling aspects of modern physics, from the behavior of electromagnetic fields to quantum phenomena like spooky action at a distance. Perhaps these effects arise from complex waveforms propagating through an underlying medium, some even exceeding the speed of light. Though Einstein rejected the ether, the idea may never have left us. In today's scientific lexicon, we speak of the quantum vacuum and the zero-point energy field. The terminology has evolved, but the essence remains. Space is not empty, it is structured, active, and perhaps, as the ancients once believed, alive with energy. In the next episode of the Misconception series, part 10, we will look at another common question. Why doubt the Big Bang?